Schools record their decisions about relative achievement on the form R6. Making these decisions involves using all of the evidence in a student folio to determine a level of achievement in accordance with syllabus requirements, and a finer-grained relative achievement decision in relation to the standards descriptors in the syllabus. The syllabus prescribes what the minimum requirements are to award a level of achievement. The standard awarded is an on-balance judgment about how the qualities of the student's work match the standards descriptors overall in each dimension. For example, to achieve a B in one dimension, there may be some C qualities in the student's work, but on balance, the work is better matched to the B descriptors. A syllabus may describe a high achievement at exit as a standard B in any two dimensions and no less than a C in the remaining dimension. Making a relative achievement decision about where to place the student on the form R6 involves reviewing all of the evidence in the student folio, which contains responses to a variety of assessment instruments under a range of conditions. Standards describe the qualities in student work that are typical. When making a finer-grained decision, the teacher needs to look at the qualities of the student's work relative to the standards. Relative achievement decisions are made by looking at the extent to which the standards have been achieved across the dimensions of the syllabus at, for example, a threshold, low, typical, or better than typical standard. There may be a number of students whose achievement might be considered typical. Those students may all have been awarded on balance a B in each of the dimensions. However, when making fine-grained decisions, the school needs to look at the qualities of the student's work relative to the standards. For example, within each B, there may be some of the student's work that matches to descriptors below, or a C, and some may have descriptors or qualities matching the A. So therefore, there might be three students whose profiles look the same, B, B, B. But the school may place one student on an HA4, another on HA5, and another at an HA6. This is fine-grained decision-making. In this example, the student has achieved an A in one dimension and B's in the other two dimensions. The school might consider this folio as a better than typical HA. The student has not met the minimum requirements for a VHA, but they are close to that because they're at the upper range relative to the A standard. The two dimensions judged on balance as B have A qualities, but not so many as to be judged an A overall. The folio might be placed as a high HA. A threshold decision may be represented by a B in one dimension, perhaps with some C qualities, but not enough to be a C on balance. Another dimension might also be B on balance, with some C qualities, while the third dimension might be a C overall, with some D qualities evidenced in the work. This folio might be placed as a threshold HA. So, schools make judgments about student achievement using evidence of the match of student responses to assessment instruments with the syllabus standards, to firstly make a level of achievement decision in relation to the syllabus requirements, and secondly, a relative achievement decision in relation to the extent to which the standards have been achieved on balance across the dimensions.